Now, Dutch attacked the Portuguese in 1607, 29th August, defeated them and took over the coast. And before that, Dutch attacked the Portuguese two times, but the Portuguese defeated them. Now, when they came the third time, they map up different strategy because most of the attacks came from Seville. But the third one, some of them came from England. And they said some of the locals also helped the Dutch because they were fed up in the Portuguese. When the Portuguese were cheating them, the scale that they used in measuring, they adjusted so that the locals felt cheated. And also there was an agreement or a law which was signed between the Portuguese and then the locals. It was regimental law. And that law stated that the locals should only trade with the Portuguese and not any other company. So when you are caught trading outside the Portuguese, you cut off one of your ears to the extent of even killing some of them. So they were not happy with that law, thinking that that way they are slaves. So they have the Dutch, some came. So when they defeated the Portuguese, they put up this one to check England and the castle as well. And they also continued, and the Dutch also spent 235 years here. As I said, the Dutch were here, British were at Cape Coast, and Danish were also in Accra. And apart from the three castles, this was, they built more than 40 along the coast of this country. Some of them also had to hold slaves also for the same trade. But 1807, slave trade was abolished by the British. Though illegally they were doing this, but they were not using the main castles. And 1814, Dutch also abolished it. So I think from that time onwards, the castle wasn't profitable again. Now, Dutch sold this castle to the British in 1872. Now, when you follow the history, Dutch and British swapped possessions. The British were having a fort in northern Sumatra in Indonesia. They gave that fort to the Dutch, and Dutch handed this one to them. But they paid something because castle is bigger than the fort. Now, when British took over, they brought strong men here. And the men that were brought here were African, they were blacks. They were from West Africa, and also only the English-speaking countries in West Africa. British trained them here, and the men were fighting for the British during the Second World War. They fought for them in Burma and India. The name of the men were known as Royal West African Frontier Force. Royal West African Frontier Force. And after the Second World War, British used this castle as police training school in 1948. They were training policemen. Now, British were here, so Ghana became independent state in 1957. They also left. Ghanaians took over. But later, this castle was designated by UNESCO as one of the World Heritage Monuments in 1971. And this is the oldest and the largest castle in the world in terms of transatlantic slavery. The only African of transatlantic slavery is the oldest and the largest. As it stands now, the castle is 539 years old.
It's still standing.